Hello everyone. So today we'll study the components of ecosystem, both biotic and abiotic factors in detail, ecotone, niche and its type. So ecosystem is a complex set of relationship among the habitats of an area. It includes plants, trees, animals, microorganisms, water, soil, etc. Ecosystem may vary greatly in size. An ecosystem can be as small as a single tree and as large as an entire forest. So now we'll see the components of ecosystem. So first we'll see biotic factors. So biotic factor includes non-living and inorganic substances such as carbon, nitrogen and other physical factors. The most important ones are temperature, water, light and soil. So temperature is the most ecologically relevant environmental factor, and the average temperature on land varies seasonally. It decreases progressively from the equator towards the pole, and with that the distribution of species also decreases on the either side of the equator towards the pole. So we all know that the biodiversity in the equatorial region is very high in compared to the polar region. So we can divide organism on the basis of temperature in two parts. One is eurythermal and the other is stenothermal. Eurythermal are the organism that can tolerate and thrive in wide ranges of temperature, for example cat, dog and tiger. And stenothermal are the organism that have the ability to tolerate only a narrow range of temperature, for example penguin, python and crocodile. So after temperature, water is the most important factor influencing the life of the organism. The distribution of plants and animals are heavily dependent on water. Take the example of desert and tropical forest. And for the aquatic animal, the quality or the pH level, that is the salt concentration of the water, becomes important. So on the basis of water, aquatic animals are divided into two categories, urealine and stenohaline. So urealine are the aquatic animal that can tolerate wide range of salinities, and stenohaline are the organism that can tolerate only a narrow range of salinity. Then we have light, and we know that plant produces food through photosynthesis, for which they need sunlight as a source of energy, and also the availability of sunlight determines the temperature, which is the most important abiotic factor. And the last one is soil. So the nature and the property of soil is different in different places, which determines the vegetation of that place to a large extent. And this in turn also determines the type of animal found in that particular area. So these were the four most important abiotic factors. And then we have biotic factors. And this includes living organism comprising plants, animals, microbes, and are classified as primary producer and consumer. So primary producer or autotrophs are organisms that can produce its own food using light, water, carbon dioxide and other chemicals. Example, for terrestrial plants and for aquatic, various species of microscopic algae. Then we have consumers or heterotrophs. These are organisms that cannot manufacture its own food and instead obtain its energy and food by taking in substances, usually from plants and animal matter. For example, all animals and even plants, for example pitcher plants, are carnivorous and feed on organisms like insects. So in consumers, we have two types of consumers, macro consumers and micro consumers. Macro consumers are the ones who feed on plants or animals or both. So in micro consumer, we have primary consumer, secondary consumer and tertiary consumer. So primary consumers are also called herbivorous. They feed on plants, for example, grasshopper. Secondary consumers, they feed on primary consumer, for example, frog. And tertiary consumers are also called carnivorous. They feed on secondary consumer, for example, snake. And in that we have omnivores also. So they consume both plants and animals, for example, man. Then the second category is microconsumers, also called saprotrophs, also called decomposers. They are bacteria or fungi which obtain energy and nutrients by decomposing dead organic substances, that is called detritus, of plants and animals. So the soil organisms who feed on detritus are called detrivores, for example earthworms, nematodes and arthropods. So then we have ecotone. So ecotone is the transition area between two diverse ecosystems, for example mangrove forest. So mangrove forests represent the ecotone between marine and terrestrial ecosystem. So the increased biodiversity in this zone is called edge effect, and the organisms which occur most abundantly in this zone are known as edge species. Then we have niche. So ecological niche is the role or position a species has in its environment. How it survives, how it reproduces. A species niche include all its interaction with the biotic and abiotic factor of its environment. A niche is unique for a species, which means no two species will have exact identical niche. Then we have four types of niche. Habitat niche, where the species lives. food niche, what it eats and decomposes, reproductive niche, how and when it reproduces, and the last one, physical and chemical niche, the temperature, land, humidity and other requirements. In the next video, we'll see various biomes in detail.